Okay, story time. Just the other night, my blog professor sent me a message asking me on Telegram to check my NUS email. And safe to say, I was flummoxed because apparently my whole stay was terminated last week. Yeah. Okay, so what happens is that for students in NUS that stay on campus, we have to do FET testing weekly, and for those that are unvaccinated, we have to do it bi-weekly. So after I recovered from the virus, I did not do an FET test for the next 3 weeks or so because, yeah, I just forgot to do it, you know, I just recovered, I didn't really need to care, right? Well, wrong, because, yeah, I've gotten terminated. So I forgot to apply for exemption from FET, which is available for those that have gotten the booster jab, which I just got last Saturday. In any case, I managed to get an extension from the hall master himself, and I will be able to stay on campus for this remaining week before I officially get kicked out. I'm gonna hold a party for myself. I don't know what I'm going to be doing in this party. I literally just came up with the idea like half an hour ago. This video is also for me to fulfill any collaborations that I've been putting off for maybe more than a month or almost 2 months. Man has been really busy trying to get his life together and getting work done. So yeah. And with that, let's hold a party. As part of having a quick party, we need to get some food, right? Well, turns out I already got myself some food, which I have right here in this fridge. The last time Fridge Kun made an appearance on my vlog, it was back when I first moved in. We've had a long journey together, Fridge Kun. Thank you so much for stocking up all the meat that I always use to cook my pasta. But I'm not gonna be eating pasta today. I still have this milk. I do have this Strong Zero beer that I bought from Don Don Donki. Got some green tea. Aha! Here it is. Got myself some sushi for later. Yeah. And this Punggol Nasi Lemak chili has been in there for a hell of a long time. Oh man, nasty. I guess, yeah, that's the food settled then. What do I do next? Oh well, let's go skate around the hall.
Carl, I'm having a solo party tonight, unless you want to come join. Ah! Kao Yuen, come join.
Me and JK.
Oh yeah, how you and JK go hunt already. Hai shi.
Hey la, bo pian. I guess I am going to be enjoying this solo party myself tonight.
Yeah, this one right here goes out to all the babies, mamas. Baby mama's mama. Yeah, go like this. I'm sorry, Miss Jackson. Ooh, I am for real. Never meant to make your daughter cry. I apologize.
Okay, so next up, on our right, we have the gym. Yeah, you can't really see it. Passing by quite quickly. There's someone in the gym right now. Not gonna disturb him. Ooh! And next, we have the dark room, aka the Shears Media Room. Let me see if I still have access. Yeah!
Beautiful. Oh shit, look at this mess.
Okay, one thing I am not going to miss about hall is the filth that we live in sometimes, because this is disgusting. Like, look at this pile of crap over here, man. But yeah, that's a part of the charm of communal living, I guess. The media team in Shears has a really nice setup. We have studio lighting, we have a backdrop with multiple colors at the back, we have props, and we have a really nice lineup of camera gear over here, which I for sure took a lot of advantage of in my first year and second year.
Sonys, we got speed lights. We also have this plush over here. They bought it when I was a year one. No comments about its phallic nature.
And wow, yeah, this is probably the last time I am ever going to be in here. You know what? Let me use the studio one last time before I dip out of Shears Hall for good. So what's going to be upcoming is my ad role for Odyssey Bot. Take it away, sellout Dago. Oh hi! Totally didn't see the camera right there. So for those of you that have been following my socials, you will know that I have picked up longboarding as a new hobby for the past month or so, and I am absolutely loving it so far. So courtesy of Odyssey Boards, they have sent me their iconic Nahoa version 2 42-inch longboard. Nahoa means daring and defiant, paying homage to the inspiration for its design. And dare I say it, when I'm on this board, it makes me feel bold, defiant and daring. As much so as when I do the power pose. Bold, defiant, daring. The deck itself is made from a fusion of the East and West, a combination of vertically laminated wood from the Penta delicacy of bamboos, as well as the Canadian maple trees of the Maple Syrup Kingdom, Canada. To put it simply, this board, strong as hell, and can even hold someone like me whose legs are so big like pork that I must go to exercise. And because Odyssey Boards wants to give back to the very forest that have made these adventures possible, they are running the Skate for Trees project, where 3 trees will be planted for every board sold. They have paired up with the non-profit organization One Tree Planted, where they are going to be planting trees in Vietnam, the Philippines and Indonesia. And lastly, so that your new longboard doesn't just sit in the corner and collect dust, all customers get a free longboard fundamentals class along with their longboard purchase. And this class will equip you with the skills that you would need to cruise and explore Singapore on a longboard. Thank you again to Odyssey Boards for sending over this longboard to me. And for anyone that wants to get discounts off longboard purchases on Odyssey Boards, feel free to use my code down in the video description below. And yeah, that's about it for Sellout Dago for Odyssey Boards. Hang loose! Took way longer than I thought it would, and now I'm heading back to the rooftop and my block to catch the sunset, because the sunsets are real gorgeous at this time of the day and I don't want to miss it, and I want to show it to you guys. Woo.
Okay, just a quick one before my camera runs out of battery. Wow, look at that. Look at that. This is definitely a view that I'm going to miss when I move out. So one thing I really love about staying in Shears Hall, especially on the rooftop floor, we have this totally unobstructed view of the entire skyline in its entirety. No high buildings blocking the view whatsoever.
Just pure unobstructed sky. The air here is... One thing that's actually really underrated is how peaceful this area actually is. I really like the fact that it's all low-rise buildings around me. It gives me a very clear view of the entire space. So I'm just gonna enjoy this sunset a little bit more. Enjoy the present, like I've always been preaching for the past few videos. Yeah, I'm gonna stop recording right now. See you guys in a bit. Almost 8 p.m. right now, so I guess it's almost time for me to get my food out and have a swell little solo party in this room. I also have this thing that I'm going to open right now. Say hello to the Lumos Nano. And this is a portable projector. I'm just gonna set this up and put a voiceover. Honestly, this is a really nifty product that I do want to share with you guys, so I'm gonna go set it up right now and watch a show on this blank wall over here. Yeah, let's go!
A few moments later.
Okay, so before I talk about this projector over here, I want to thank Lumos for sending this projector over to me. So here are some of the perks of the Lumos Nano, which is this model that you're seeing right here. As its name states, the Lumos Nano is extremely portable because of its really small size. Here are just some items I found for a size comparison. And you can see it's really, really small. And it only comes at 400 grams. Some other perks of the Nano include its inbuilt speaker, which was surprisingly good actually. I was not expecting it to have this much depth. Let me just play this sound test real quick. 20, 22, side coming back. Yeah. Long time no see, huh? Because there's an inbuilt Android OS in there, the Lumos Nano itself has Netflix as well as YouTube that's built in. So if you want to watch some of your favorite creators or binge some Netflix with your friends, the Lumos Nano has got you covered. If you're like me, you can also connect a HDMI cable from the projector itself to a laptop. It's really just a big ass screen for you to use. It uses premium DLP tech with over 1500 lumens. Basically, the projector is bright and can display vivid colors. And one other thing that I kind of like, the projector is able to automatically shift its perspective such that when you display it on a wall, the screen is going to be straight, even if you're pointing it from the side. So yeah, that's the Lumos Nano for you. And I do have something exciting that I want to announce. So Lumos has also sent me their Lumos Ray projector, and I'm going to be giving this away on my Instagram page. So if you want to know more about this giveaway, head over to my Instagram page and you'll find the details there. And with that, I'm gonna continue on with my solo party. I'm gonna watch this anime called Spy X Family while eating my mentaiko salmon sushi and having the time of my life.